Hello friend, welcome to lecture on PHP. And as you know, I have taken lots of lecture on PHP programming. PHP is an open source programming language for web development, server development. So today I am discussing here about PHP client server connectivity, get and post method. And already I have taken one lecture on this get and post and client server connectivity. So you can see here, basically we create the forms. So when we write the program, then we start by question mark PHP, and we have been get method as well as we have been post method. So post method is more secure than the get method. To access the HTTP post and get data is simple in PHP, and we have been these $_post and then square bracket means for the array also, and $_get contain the request data. So these are the functions which we will use for the requesting data from the client. So you can see here, this is the program. This program is client-side program and above program, and the first program is the server-side program. So on this client-side program, we will start the program by form action form1.php and method equals to post, and input type submit, name is submit, means we have been two button, first button is submit and second button is cancel. So again we have mentioned here, input type submit, we have two buttons, submit button first, submit button to second, and the name of this submit button is submit and cancel is the name of the second button, and your caption is submit as well as cancel. So as we will click on submit, so accordingly its value is submit and its name is submit also. It is capital letter, it is in small letter. So same way we are doing this program, and we have been another program, that is the server program. So as we will click on the button, any one of the button, we have been two button. So as we will click on the button, it will activate this form.php, and the first program is the form.php and method equals to post. So as we will press on any one of button, we have been two button, if we are pressing first button, then it will start form.php, second button, in that case also it will start form.php. In both cases, in both both operation, clicking on the button 1 and clicking on the button 2, it will start form1.php. So you can see here question mark PHP, and we have written here if $_post and submit. It means if we have we are getting here the value of this first button. So in that case, if we have pressed on submit button, it means we will go here in if, in this if, and in this condition will true, post $_post $_post submit. So it means we have pressed on the submit button, and in that case it will display the message on heading 2, click the submit button. And otherwise we will move on this if condition, and here we have mentioned here if $_post cancel, it means we have pressed on the cancel, so it will return true. But when we have pressed on this cancel, then it will return cancel is the name of variable. When we have pressed on the cancel button, then it will retrieve the value of this it will true value of the this post function, and accordingly it will display you clicked cancel. So these are the two output. Accordingly, when we will press on this button, then it will display this output, otherwise it will display this output. And this is form1.php. as we will click on these any one of these two buttons, so accordingly it will display the message. So these are the two programs. This is the client program and this is the server program. So I have already discussed you in the previous lecture. So here we have also used the same pattern. So we have been two program. The first program is the index.jsp and the second one is the welcome.php. So here we have been two text boxes, name and A, and we have big one submit button. Here we have only one submit button. As we will click on this submit button, so it will start welcome.php, and this welcome.php is here. So here we have mentioned here dollar post and then name of the variable. This is the name of the variable. So we have app name is the first text box. So we will input the value of text box. And here in the second line we have input the value of age, dollar post age. So input, we are inputting here age. So request.getParameter, this is the JSP statement, request.getParameter. Like this statement, we can use this the same pattern we are using in this program also. So you can see here, this is the request.getParameter. So this is the program where we have been two files, index.php and welcome.php. So same pattern is applied here in this program also. We have been these two files, the first file, that file will be always, it will be index.jsp file, and the second one is the form.php. So it is form.php and it is index.php, or it may be JSP, it may be HTML. But in case HTML and PHP, we can write here index.php. So and in this line, so we can write here this statement also. In case of the PHP, in case of PHP, we will write it request.getParameter, and we will write here submit. While this is the PHP. So in this PHP programming language, we will write in place of request.getParameter, we are writing here $_POST, and submit is inside the square bracket, while submit will be inside the simple bracket. So in place of, this is the same function here, in PHP we will write here $_POST, and while in JSP it will be request.getParameter. Request is a implicit object. There are 8 implicit objects in JSP. So request is the implicit object and get parameter is the function of that object. So this is the way of writing the program. So here we are getting the parameter button, and while in the previous program we are getting the parameter which are the two text boxes. So we are getting here $_POST app name, this is first text box, and $_POST age, this is the second text box, and we have been submit button. As we will click on this submit button, accordingly it will start this welcome.php. So action will start, and it will execute running this welcome.php, and this is the file welcome.php, and the first file is index.php, and we have been mentioned here post method. So in case of post is more secure, and while in second case you can see here method is get. So when we will write the method is get, then accordingly when we will execute, when as we will click on this submit button, it will start the welcome.php. When welcome.php will execute, so that time it will display the app name and age on this line, on the first line where we are writing name of website, gmail.com or readymail.com. So here it will display the value of these text box also. So it is not secure. Suppose these values are username and password. So username and password will be visible on our web browser. So it means there will be no security. So it will leak the security. So in that case, we use method equals to post. When we will write method equals to post, then it will not display this app name and age. So these are the two programs, and now you can see one more program. So in this program, we have been two files. So the first file is infoform.php, and the second file is answer. So answer.php. So we have been two files. This is the first file, and in first file we have been two fields: name, your name, as well as age. And input type text, again we have mentioned here input type text, and its variable name is name and its variable name is age. So as you will submit this form, So this is the form and input type submit button, and as we will click on the submit button, it will start action and it will run showAnswer.php, show_answer.php. So this is the second file, show_answer.php. It will start to execute this file and method equals to post. So when we will come on this file, so we have mentioned here hi ?php and php is started here, echo $_post name. So the name, we will input this name, and you are in second line again ?php echo $_post age. So in first line we are taking input age, we are getting this age from the client side and age from the client side, because in client side we have been two text box, and in these two text box we have been name and age, and we are accessing these name and age on the server. So it will display hi and the name of person and you are and it's a year old. So this will be the output. So this is the first file and this is the second file. So you have to, I suggest you that you have to practical on these programs. I have given you four example regarding these client server connectivity, and you have to implement all four example, and you have to write first you make the client program as well as server program on your computer. Same computer you prepare, same computer as a server as well as client, and then you have to do one computer as a server and another computer you should take as a client, and from client you run this program and from server you execute this program. So but both the program will be stored on the server, but this program will started from the client, means we have to write the link of this program in text.php. In this slide we have been this info.form, the name of the first program is info_form, but it should be index.php. So guys, I hope that you understand all the concept of this client server programming and get and post method. So I again suggest you that you implement these programs, and it is very easy to execute this program. So thank you guys, thank you very much.